a birthday without cake, party hats and even jelly. Beamish Museum is celebrating turning 50 this year. Over this half term, visitors are being invited to take part in the festivities right across the museum.
We've been tucking in and having a lovely time, but then someone thought it was for decoration and said, are you sure you meant to eat that? And yes, everything at Beamish is edible. More or less everything. Everything that we do at Beamish this year will be linked back to the fact that we are 50 this year. So that is absolutely fantastic. The museum has grown from strength to strength. There'll be another 50 years of you know, more of this. We're in the Welfare Hall today, and this will be, it's an ideal spot because it's undercover on a windy day like today. But every area, Pockley will be showing you what it was like in the Georgian times to have a celebration, to the pit cottages, to the town, to the 40s farm. Just the whole of the museum will really embrace this opportunity. Because, I mean, what's not to like? 50 years, you've got to make a big thing about it, haven't you?
Beamish was founded in 1970 by Frank Atkinson to help preserve the region's everyday ways of life for future generations to explore. Some buildings were moved and put back together brick by brick. 50 years on, the museum staff and volunteers bring history to life from the 1820s to the 1950s.
So I started here 25 years ago. This month I began at Beamish 25 years ago. So I remember the day, it was very cold, it was snowing, and I thought, wow, I'm actually coming to do something which I've always visited and really, really loved. And I always think back, when I'm talking to staff and volunteers now, I think back to what I felt like when I first came here and went into the music teacher's house in particular, went up to Pockley, and it meant so much to me, and I was blown away by the exhibits that I saw. So I always say to folks, try and remember what you felt like when you first went into one of those exhibits, because that's how the visitor feels when they're coming in, to be blown away by that. Blown away today because it's very, very windy, but that memory for me is really, really strong.
The museum's £20 million remaking Beamish project is currently underway. It will be the biggest development in its history. Next to the Welfare Hall, a whole 1950s town is being built. The 1820s will also expand, including a Georgian inn where visitors can stay overnight.
I sampled the blancmange and it was like a rave from the grave. It was many, many years since I had a bowl of blancmange. It took me back a lot of years. But I visited Beamish Museum from being a young man to coming on a regular basis, because it's a sort of museum that you can't see in one day or even one year. It's changing, it's ongoing. Our hall here is a new addition, and we've got a remaking Beamish programme.
Not only is the museum celebrating its golden jubilee, but also its record visitor numbers. Here's to more exciting times ahead. Sophie Helsing in County Durham.